Good afternoon. I am Dario Finardi, and I am from gear.it from Italy. And today I will talk to you about the automatic distribution of big quantity of technical manuals. The issue we faced and solved are mainly related to legal and usability requirements, and I'd like to describe them with a use case approach. But before proceeding, let me better introduce the theme. You shall imagine a machinery producer producing dozens of plants per year, each long more than 300 meters and accompanied by 1,000 multi-language manuals with tables, schemes, and a lot of details. In a few years, the quantity of managed document by the producer becomes unmanageable. And what does the producer think about those manuals? They are a legal requirement and should be written in more than a language to make the content accessible to the target audience. The producer is always looking for a way to make the delivery and updating phases as simple and as cheap as possible. He is improving content accessibility to bring better training and usage, and is willing to improve the user experience to make to improve the user experience to make user loyalty greater. What about the customer point of view? Also for the customer, the instruction and maintenance manual is an important tool. It should be always accessible, at least during the complete machinery's life cycle, which could be 15 or 20 years long, sometimes even longer. For this reason, long-term archiving procedures, reprinting and reproduction of contents are strictly needed. Properly archived and organized manuals should offer better access and search. And also for the customer, the training, the handling, and the storage phases are a hot topic. This is a brief and incomplete list of features comparing the printed and the digital manuals. The digital version is more eco-sustainable, and the digital version gives the producers and the customers a set of improved features, like, for example, better searching, shared annotation in between the work team, availability of multimedia contents to make the training phase simpler, and the direct integration between the manuals and the machinery, exploiting the network of IoT sensors. What does the law require about manuals and digital media, which are the issue related to law? I am from Europe, and in Europe, machinery producer and user should follow the directive on machinery, written in 2006. And what does the directive say about the medium of distribution? Currently, the directive really says nothing about the topic. It focuses on contents, on structure, and other details, but not saying nothing about the use media to distribute the contents themselves. When the producers develop the machinery and these manuals, this should comply with the directive, but not only. There are also different standard requirements that they shall follow. And let me give a couple of important examples. One document other than the directive is the so-called Guide on the Machinery Directive, which is not a binding law. It's a support for both the producer and the users, which simplifies their work when studying and understanding the directive. The guide, written in 2009, contains a paragraph about health and safety manuals. It says that health and safety information shall be provided by paper, but the electronic form is a desideratum to override the paper destruction and its loss. The guide is also stressing that connection to the internet is not a reliable media and that the end user could not own the proper device to read digital contents. And I'd like to underline again that the guide was written for the first time in 2009 and that paragraph never has been updated for the first, very first release. The second important example is from ISO. At the end of May, ISO approved the update of the harmonization standard about the preparation of instructions for use. The standard is clear about the opportunity to distribute instruction manual in an electronic form. The standard lists a set of features and characteristics of both printed and digital manuals. For example, the paper version should be characterized by page numbering and a clear table of contents. The digital version should offer advanced search engines, hyperlinks, and if possible, multimedia to improve the training. Last but not least, the important question is if electronic manuals are really allowed aside of a complex machinery. And when we began our work, the answer was not so clear. But now I can answer yes, electronic is allowed. There is a single constraint, and it's from the guide of on the directive. And the constraint is only about the health and the safety documentation, not manuals of use and maintenance. And following the requirement from the directive and the ISO standard, we are also sure that the best way to distribute digital manuals is by using PDF-A format. In addition to legal ones, we faced also requirements related to usability and the contents accessibility. For example, to comply with the requirement of ISO about enhanced search engines, we developed an automatic approach to build complete indexes of the full manuals library. To do it, we scan each incoming PDF file and evaluate if it's properly built with good encoding and the proper sequence of characters. And we check many parameters from each glyph on the page, like the size, the position, the font face. But if the PDF is poorly encoded, we run an OCR scanning to introduce the next analysis phase, which is the extraction of each sentences and clauses from each page and the evaluation of the proper language and after that the application of a semantic and sentiment analysis. The last activity allows us to set the properly tag to each sentence. And when the index is complete, we write a JSON stream and attach it to the original PDF file. The result of our analysis is summarized by these four attributes. The text, which is the sentence just extracted from the manual. The salience, which is the list of the most relevant words from the text. And the sentiment, which expresses if the words from the salience list are used in a positive or a negative way. And analyzing text, salience, and the sentiment, we are able to properly apply a tag list and load it in the type attribute. Currently, we are also improving the sentiment analysis, introducing artificial intelligence and image recognition. And we base this analysis on the detection of legally compliant icons and glyphs placed on the manuals aside of the text. Also, multimedia play was an issue we had to face when approaching to embedded devices of machinery sidelines. Multimedia from PDF file is usually applied by means of rich media annotation, which are not often supported by very simple reader running on embedded operating system and devices. So we decided to override the conventional way PDFs deliver multimedia, and we extract rich media stream, analyze it, and when we find a non-standard format, we re-encode it. For example, when we find an FLV video stream, we re-encode it as an MPEG-4 file format, and then attach the stream to the original PDF file. Optionally, we remove the rich media annotation and substitute it with a properly formatted hyperlink. That's because the PDF reader we found on the embedded devices are commonly able to play multimedia from a streaming web link, both from the internet or from a local web server. Earlier, I said that PDF-A is the best format for a technical manual, so we are using PDF-A Part 3. And the result we achieved by using PDF-A Part 3 are that first, each manual is a self-contained PDF document containing metadata, indexes, and multimedia. Then, each file is simple to move, to set up, and update on the target reader. And still being a PDF file, any reader allows the user to open, read, and print the document. And being a PDF-A, the long-term archiving is still a native feature. At last, also third-party developers, different from us, can access to custom data in the same way that every ERP producer can read and use the Zugfert files attached to a PDF-A Part 3 invoice. And what will happen when the PDF-A Part 4 will be released later during the year? We are working on two stunning features. The first is the support of the PDF 2.0 tag, which will improve the way we extract text and contents from manuals. And with more reliable extracted text we will have the possibility to better support displayless and voice-based devices. The second feature is the support of the PDF 3D file format, which will allow the user to improve the maintenance and the spare part management using the direct integration between manuals and 3D models. Now we are still assessing if the support of the standard PRC and the U3D format could really satisfy our customers' need, and we are evaluating whether or not to attach different file format inside the PDF file. All the information comes from our own direct experience, and I anticipated it's a kind of use case. And currently, our platform could be represented by a diagram like this, but describing it in details is not the focus of this speech. But if someone would like to know more about it, I'd be happy to have a chat later. And thank you for the quick attention. I finished.